Hello everyone, it's Francesco here and I hope you're doing well. Today we're doing a review on a software called Gripply. Now it is a task management, habit tracking, goal planning application and we're going to see whether it's worth it for you and to see whether it's your next place to plan everything. So we're going to dive into it in today's video. So here we are with Gripply in front of us. Before we jump into this video, if you are hunting for tools and resources, please do jump over to toolfinder.co to explore more tools. You'll find to-do list apps, resources, whether or whether or not you like Gripply, which if you do like Gripply, you can find it linked below. So this application works like many other to-do list applications. You can add a task here, and here you can add things like a priority level. You can add a notification when this pings off and also add a repeat schedule as well. Now the repeat schedule connects also with the habit tracking ability, which I think is a really nice feature. So in this case, I can actually remove that and I don't want to demonstrate it, but you can also see that I can add a task for tomorrow. Now anything that's given a date automatically moves over to the upcoming area because it's given a task for tomorrow. It's going to add obviously some attributes. Now down here, I can add subtasks and here I can delete it and add a description. So pretty much what you'd expect for most other task management apps, like the basics. You can also reschedule everything that's in certain things for tomorrow. And you can also see a today area. Now the today area can be modified based on a type of goal or priority. So in this case, you can organize it by life area, type of task or type of action. And you can sort the task by the priority. Now, what I want to point out is that this task management area isn't really what I would say the most amazing element of this because it does a job. Like, I wouldn't say it's particularly mind-blowing, but at the same time, it does do function. It does the basic functions which you'd expect. But this is where I believe this application excels very well at. And here is an area for work and career. So what you can do here is you can start planning your goals in this case. So in this case, you can start with a vision. You can set aside, like, I want to get the manager of the firm. And you can add an image of that from Unsplash if you want. And I'm just going to type in manager and have an image. You can add multiple images. It's almost like a mood board, which is quite nice. And here I can go into detail. I can, you know, talk away. I want to be the CEO, etc. And add everything. So it's almost like your document for you to start out with, which is quite a nice concept. And here you've got goals. So within a career basing, you can also see goals and there's also goal plans. So in this case, you can learn a new skill in there. You can steal from one of their concepts and that automatically plans in, which is really helpful to that. But in this case, I'm going to create a goal and I'm going to say win promotion because that could be a really simple first step. And you can change the image, you can select an icon for it and set a deadline. So I might want to say by the end of the month, I want to. Then you can add what's called a measure progress. So this is essentially like a way to define how is this going to be achieved. Like you could say my start value is, I believe I'm 30% there and target values are 100% and I could save that. So here, let's just say win promotion is a bit more simple than just 0 to 100. Say it is a number goal, like savings account. You can then be like, okay, I want to update my progress. Today, I have hit 45 and I want to save it. So that's a great way into being able to modify your progress. You can set this in advance, for example, like you can see how you're progressing as well. I actually had a date here, which I started. So I might start at 30. So you can see the progress there. So what I quite like about this is if it's something like weight or something like an achievement-based thing that's set, you can see exactly how you're targeting it with updates. And below that, you can also set actually action, make it actionable because you're associating a project to it. You can also add a sub-goal. So for example, a sub-goal could help to define that goal there. You can favorite these as well. So they appear on the right, left-hand side, which I quite like because that reminds me of things three. So ignore the moped in the background. And you can also, if you heard it, and you can also see how long's left and how long's completed. So initially, I really like this. So you can see the vision, you can see the goals, and you can see the tasks associated with it. So that could even be like, go out and buy a new suit because it's task associated, where this is a bit more numerically associated. But you can also assign tasks to it. So that's what I think is the most compelling element of this. And you can see as well, a bit of a zoom out option as well. So in this case, I don't know what Life Scan does. I'm yet to fully understand that feature. But as you can see like everything, active goals completed, how you progress. And you can also choose to add an additional life area. You could have a spiritual one, an education one, a fun relaxation one. I think this is a really nice feature. Because it centralizes everything you're doing, then you can see these goals as a separate type experience, and you can also track your habits. So in this case, I want to say meditate, and you can repeat every Monday, you know, when I haven't got the kids. And you can also set a priority level on as well. So in this case, you can also attach it to a goal if you want to. But in this case, I could go Monday, Friday, and I did it on Tuesday, and you can see a progress bar. Now, this isn't going to be mad analytics and mad insights like that. It's not going to be something that mind-blowingly habit tracking, but being able to see your habits alongside with your goals is a really nice addition. So I really like the way that this application is set up. Inside of settings, there are a few things that you can set up the tasks. I'm on the premium already. I believe they granted me access. So I'll include some of the pricing at the start of this video, because I know people will like that. I'll make sure to edit that in. But largely, the concept is really compelling, I think. And it's sort of like a very much a zoomed out approach, a little bit like Timestripe and other such options. So I hope you enjoyed that review of Gripply, a interesting app with good mobile access, a zoomed out focus on your planning. Maybe not the best to-do list application if you're looking for a replacement, but something that is slightly different from what you might be doing now. So thank you so much for stopping by in this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Please do check out Toolfinder if Gripply wasn't your option today. But of course, you can find out more resources, more guides, more reviews over there too. Thanks so much for stopping by. Have a great day. Check out Gripply if you liked it below, and I'll see you in a future video. Cheerio.